ハローエブリバディ。Welcome to 将棋ラーメン TV。いらっしゃいませ。Let's enjoy 将棋 with me. Today, I will introduce the importance of the turn, especially in the endgame. Let's see this position. This position is completely even. But if the center has a turn, center can win easily by dropping the silver. Or dropping the bishop. But if the Gote has a turn, Gote will win easily. This dropping silver is very strong and it's difficult to defense. So in the endgame, the turn is very important. Which has a turn is very important point. So in this video, I will introduce the examples and the techniques about the turn. Let's see. This is very famous and basic techniques to continue the turn. And in this situation, you can drop the silver to fork the gold and rook. And this is the basic way to keep the turn because the rook has to escape and take the gold. And take the silver by gold or by rook. Let's see this position. In this situation, you have the turn, but the opponent castle has been weakened by the dropping the silver. So in this attack, you can keep the turn and you can continue attack. So this kind of the dropping the silver is very useful way to continue your attack. This is very basic but useful. This is also the famous and basic techniques using the pawn to keep the turn. So in this position, dropping the pawn is the nice way. If the knight escape, you can create the promoted pawn. This is very strong. So the opponent has to take the pawn by gold. This gold move is bad because far from his king. So after that, for example, you can prepare to attack the king. And this gold needs to move to near the king, but you can drop the pawn to continue the attack. Take by gold. And you can continue dropping the bishop. So this is you are just sacrifice the two pawns, but you can continue the attack. The rook moving here, and the bishop is dropped here. So just dropping the pawn is a very basic way to continue the attack. This is example of the techniques to get the turn in the defense. So now opponent dropped this rook and you need to protect by dropping the gold. But this is just defense and the opponent can continue the attack. So but in that situation there is a technique to dropping the pawn. This is an interesting technique to get the turn with the defense. If the take by rook, you can drop the gold. And this is defense and creating the castle and attack to the rook. So if rook escaped, you can get the turn and you can attack or more defense in this situation. So dropping the pawn is very important technique to get the turn. Also the techniques for the defense. Now opponent drops the bishop for the check. If you drop the silver, it's very strong defense, but the opponent can continue attack like the dropping the knight. So how to do that? Dropping the pawn is the interesting technique. If the take by bishop, you can drop the silver. So this is not only for the defense, but also the attacking to the bishop. So the bishop needs to escape. So then you got the chance, and you got the turn, and you can continue defense, or you can attack to the opponent king. This example is also the technique by using the pawn. In this position, if you want to drop the bishop here, but this gave the turn to the opponent. So how to do that? So dropping the pawn is an interesting technique. If the rook don't take this pawn, this rook doesn't work. So if the rook take this pawn, you can drop the bishop. This is attack to the rook and attack to this diagonal line. So if they escape the rook, so now you have the turn. So you lost just one pawn, but you got the turn. And this is very important technique. This example is using the lance case. So in this position, rook is attacking to the gold. You can easily defend by the dropping pawn, but the opponent can continue attack. So if we want to get the turn, the dropping the lance is the interesting way. This lance will be killed by dropping the pawn soon, but you get the turn and you can continue. You can attack by the another way. So in the end game, this kind of the dropping the lance is sometimes very useful against the rook. Let's see the real game example. This was my game, and this is my turn. And in this position, I want to capture the opponent rook, but he can escape to the right side now. So if I drop something here, next I can drop the pawn and capture the rook, but I give the turn to the opponent, so the opponent can attack, drop the knight or something. So the initiation, how to capture the rook and how to continue attack by the continuous getting turn. So the techniques is always using the pawn. This pawn is the way to continue the turn. Get the by gold. I drop the knight. This knight is attacked to the gold, so the gold needs to escape. And then I can drop the pawn to capture the rook. This is the interesting way to continue the turn. And getting the turn is very important to win the game. Let's see this position. This is very rare case, but interesting. I will introduce. So now, rook is checking to my king. If I have the pawn, I will drop the pawn here and take the rook and drop the gold. And rook need to escape. Then I got the turn. But now, I don't have the pawn, so the sacrifice of the lance is not so good. So in this situation, let's see the opponent king position. This position is on the line of the bishop here. So in this situation, dropping the bishop is an interesting defense to get the turn. So this is defense against the rook, but also, attack to the king, it's check, so the opponent need to defend something, for example, dropping the pawn. So in this situation, you got the turn, and you can attack to the king. So if the opponent has a lance, the dropping the lance is also block the bishop and check to the king. So you have to defense drop something. So you lose a turn. But if you have knight, this is also interesting defense. This is defense, but and also check to the king. So the king need to escape. And you got a turn. You can attack. So this kind of the defense with the check is very interesting, but it's rare. Okay. Thank you for watching my video about the turn. I introduced some examples about the turn. So it's very important in the end game to think about getting turn. Let's run them and enjoy playing in the end game. Thank you very much. See you next ramen. Bye bye.